go three lovely young ladies from 9 to 5.
Hey y'all. Thanks for letting us have and use a little bit of your space. My name is Cecia and I'm a housing organizer with 9 to 5 Colorado. And I want to say 9 to 5 will be lobbying and supporting the Right to Rest Act bill. So something I want to say that everybody else is ignoring in this day besides folks that are actually being impacted is that we're having a housing crisis in Colorado that could not be ignored. Our folks are not being, it's not just gentrification, they're being displaced and they're being kicked out of this city and out of the surrounding cities in Colorado. We need to find a way and solutions to be able to fight back. So we've created a coalition called Colorado Homes for All, and it's different groups all over the state that are doing work on the local grounds, whether they are working with tenants or mobile home residents or homeowners, folks that are fighting to live in a place that's accessible. And so we've created this coalition, and our biggest vision is around rent control. Even though folks don't want to talk about it and legislators are a little bit afraid of that word, but this year we're going to be working around things like maintenance issues. So we know that aside from folks paying almost 100% of their income towards rent, they're living in horrible conditions. Think of how many times you have lived in a place that was not habitable, but you had to live there because you couldn't break your lease, or how much you've paid for application fees when you didn't get that apartment and nobody ever called you back. And you were paying for you or a family of four, paying to even find a place to live, where there's no accountability, there's no one regulating anything. So we have different policies that we work on. We're a grassroots-based organization. We believe that people that are affected and impacted by the housing crisis should lead the fight, it should be at the forefront of it. So it's awesome that y'all are here advocating for yourselves, and these people work for you, right? They need to listen to what you need, because this is your city, this is your state. And so this year, make sure that they hear your voice. We're gonna be partnering up, we're gonna be supporting y'all. And if you wanna know more, we're gonna have information on what Colorado Homes for All is. We want to make this national movement of folks that are affected by this, that are directly impacted by the housing crisis. Other folks get to go home. They get to go home and not worry about what it's like to live in a place that doesn't have heat or where their money's going to come for to pay rent for next month. But we don't want our folks to be living like that. Folks that are writing policy, that are passing policy, need to be able to experience that. Thank you. Yeah.
My name is Dre. I also am a housing organizer for 9 to 5 Colorado. So like my coworker Cecia said, the two bills that we're running this year is limit application costs so landlords cannot profit, which sounds pretty sensible, but right now there's no cap on application costs at all. The other one is warranty of habitability to strengthen protections for people experiencing maintenance issues. And then the other one is around transit. If y'all know who we are, we've been working for formal transit for like 4 years now, and RTD hasn't done shit for us. So we've been fighting for an income-based pass for folks that need it, just a 50% reduced rate. And now at the state capitol this year, there's funding for that. And we created a bill during the special session in November so that this program can finally be funded. And RTD was neutral on that bill. They were neutral on getting money for RTD to provide an income-based pass. So this bill is gonna be up again during the session, and we need folks' support. It's called the vendor fee tax reduction bill. So if transit is an issue for you and you are paying full price and you can't, please let us know as well. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Caitlin. I'm also with 9 to 5. I want to let you guys know about another bill that we're working on this legislative session. It's called the Family Bill. And we're fighting for this because caring for a loved one, a new baby, an aging parent, it's a part of life. And it's a right to do that should be afforded to everyone. But right now, 88% of Coloradans do not have paid leave to care for themselves in a medical situation or to take care of a family member who's dealing with a medical situation as well. And we don't think that anyone should have to choose between their job, which can be their ability to keep themselves and their family afloat financially, or having to be there for a new baby or another family member or valuing their own health. So the Family Act, which we are fighting for, will allow workers to take that needed time off while their wages are being replaced during that time. And we think valuing our own health, caring for our families is not just a right that is given to those who are wealthy, to those like 12% of Coloradans. So it's definitely time that we pass the Family Act. Families deserve to be able to have paid leave to care for themselves and loved ones. So if this is a situation that resonates with you, we would definitely love to hear from you and work on this together. Thank you.
Thank you.